Hello, it's Galina Filipenko for Tonic Studios. Today I want to talk about nuvomusas. Nuvomusas are very versatile products. Each mousse comes in a round container and I love to store them in this round felt box. And I store them with a piece of transparent foil under the lid, but here I have them ready to work. Nuvomusas have a nice creamy texture and can be blended with water. Before we get started, I want to go back to the basics and tell you about tools for nuvomusas. You can apply nuvomousse with a dowel brush, silicone or metal spatula, blending sponges. With a dowel brush, you can apply a thin layer of mousse with or without brush strokes. This tool is perfect for blending different colors of the mousses on one surface. Dowel brushes can work with stencil if you want to apply mousse without a texture, and you can create a smooth edges of the pattern. Depends on the amount of layers you applied with brush through the stencil, you can get a little texture. With a metal palette knife, you can easily cover big surfaces with the mousses. It's a perfect tool for applying mousse through the white stencil. Round tip will help to add details on your project. You can use a palette knife to add more texture by tapping it over the wet mousse. This tool works perfectly with the stencil and I always use it if I want to add texture patterns on my projects. Here you can see the difference between using a dual brush and a palette knife. Blending sponges are perfect for covering a small areas with mousses. You can create a nice gradient on the cards or on the small embellishments. They are washable and can be reused over and over. I love to use this tool with a stencil when I want to create a focal point on the patterns. Here I'm showing how I'm going to highlight the flower with a gold color of mousse. And now let's move to the first card and technique. I call it a masking spotlight. On a piece of masking paper, I stamped a big flower from Peony Bloom stamp set, and I cut it out with a thin outline. I attach the flower on a white card panel and I'm going to cover the whole card panel with the four different colors of nuvomousses. I'm using a dowel brush because I want to create a gradient between all the colors. I started with a dark green shade, then I applied light green shade with a white color on the top. It's not actually a white color, it has a nice ivory shade. On the bottom, I decided to add a gold color. All colors I used you can find in the video description below. Next, I'm carefully removing the masking paper from the card panel. And I'm going to stamp a flower inside of this white gap. I'm using black Nuvo Hybrid ink and a large transparent acrylic block. Next, I heat embossed a sentiment on a piece of black cardstock with a white embossing powder. And I want to cut a small stripe and use it on the card. I could never cut a straight strip with scissors, but now I have a solution. I bought a special transparent tool for my glass mat from Tim Holtz, and I'm cutting a stripe with a knife from Tonic Studios. I'm going to glue the sentiment under the flower. And here is my finished card with the first card example. On the second one, I didn't add a sequence and I put the flower a little bit higher. For the second technique, I need to apply nuvomousses on a flat glass or plastic surface. If you don't have a glass mat, use an acrylic block. I'm adding a small amount of water to get a more liquid texture of mousse. I'm mixing a bit mousses with the water using a palette knife. And now I'm going to use mousse for stamping. For this technique, I recommend to use a simple images without a lot of lines. For example, I'm using a small leaf from Flowers for You stamp set. I put it on a small acrylic block and I'm taping it on the mousse and then stamp it on the cardstock. For the better result, put the stamp in the mousse only one time and then stamp. You will need to put the stamp in the mousse each time before stamping. You can combine as many colors of mousses as you want. You can get a multicolored stamped images on the different surfaces. After the mousse dries, stamped images will become permanent with a light metallic glow. Don't be afraid about using stems with mousses. Simply clean them with water or baby wipe after you're done with the stamping. I decided to finish the pattern by adding a green and gold dots around the leaves. I'm using a back tip of the paintbrush to add the dots. Here's my finished pattern with the card I made before. You can find all photos in the post in Tonyuk's blog. I will leave a link in the description below. I embellished the card with a floral die cut I made using Best Wishes Sentiment die set. I cut it out from a green mirror cardstock and it looked fabulous with the shimmering leaves. So with my second pattern, I'm going to create a simple matching wrapping for the box with candies. And I'm going to send this little present with a card to my friend just to brighten up her day. I glued the stamped paper on the back and I added more sentiment from the green cardstock. I love the cool look of a card and a matching wrapping paper. It was fun to play with this easy stamping technique. And now let's move to the more tricky technique. Maybe you will need a little bit of practice, but in result you will get a beautiful dimensional flowers. For my second card using this technique, I will create another flower composition. I cut out a circle from a heavy white cardstock. Only a heavy white cardstock will work with this technique. Using a palette knife, I pick a small amount of mousse. I pick a mousse only with the tip of the knife. And I will use only a tip to create a flower petals. You can practice on the glass mat or on the acrylic block, and after you're done, you can remove mousse back to the container. I pick a small amount of mousse and I lightly press it to the cardstock. The second petal I'm overlapping on the first one, and so on. I'm going to create a 4 and a 3 petal flowers using one red color. Feel free to combine different colors on the one flower or use different colors for each flower on your card. With such flowers, you can embellish not only a card, but a gift boxes or storage boxes, pockets and more. Or you can create a full blooming canvas and decorate the wall in your house. It's easier to apply petals with a dense mousse, so do not apply water to the pot before starting. As you can see, I'm trying to pick a mousse from the container walls where mousse is less creamy. On the bottom of each flower, I'm applying green mousse with a small spatula. I finished both cards by adding black vintage drops, which have a matte finish after drying, and they look amazing on a black card between the red flowers. Also, I decorate my cards with the die-cut sentiments. For the left one, I cut out a word hello from a white glitter cardstock. For the right card, I cut out a sentiment from the red cardstock using a die from Follow Your Dream die set. I hope you will try one of these techniques and will find more creative uses of your new mousses. That's all for today, and I'm packing back my little collection. I put a plastic foil on each container to protect mousses from drying out. Thanks for joining me today. See you soon. Bye!